In this video, we'll look at the moving speech delivered by Lou Gehrig at the Yankee Stadium in July of 1939. So this audio cleanup challenge was set for me by longtime viewer and subscriber Gary. Gary, really appreciate your comment and suggestion, and I'm doing this video for you and many others who I'm sure will find it interesting. In previous videos, I've cleaned up Sir Winston Churchill, Queen Elizabeth II, even Martin Luther King Jr. using a variety of tools, but how will this one work out for me? Well, watch to the end as I go through many different tools, including a free and easy tool, Descript's Studio Sound, then we'll hop into Adobe Audition, use some world-class tools there, and we'll end up in a premium product that you pay for, but if you've done any kind of podcast production or noise removal from anything, you've likely come across iZOTOPE RX, and we'll use that tool last. So I've just taken a little clip of the audio right here, and I've put it into Descript, which is free and easy to download. You can actually get it from mrc.fm/AI. It uses artificial intelligence to clean up your audio. Here's a little clip from Lou Gehrig.
Today, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth.
Okay, now I've specifically chosen that part of his speech because it's, well, a very famous part of his speech, but also it really exemplifies exactly what is going on there. He's speaking, and about half a second later, we're hearing some kind of splashback coming from the stadium, obviously, like as the audio travels across, we're getting like a little reflection of his audio. So what does AI do? Well, here I would just select the audio clip inside Descript. I'd add an effect, which if I haven't already done so, it would be Studio Sound, but it's already here as I added it earlier so that the processing time wouldn't take too long. Switch it on, and immediately artificial intelligence is applied to this clip, and let's listen without anything else to what it does to Lou Gehrig's speech.
Today, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth.
Now, you see, what it's done is it's taken the reflection and it's enhanced that as well using Studio Sound. So, unfortunately, AI is not smart enough to notice that exactly what is being said is being repeated half a second later, and so it's trying to clean up and improve both versions. So, you're getting today, I'm the luckiest man on the face of this earth, like that. It cannot do it. So, Descript, I'm afraid, in this instance, is a thumbs down. It doesn't work, or not at least efficiently. Maybe we can clean it up and throw something else in. Let's go back to the full speech. Let's listen from the start.
You've been reading about a bad rag.
Okay, so there's lots going on here. Now we can see once we get into Adobe Audition, which is pay monthly software, we can actually see what's happening here. Now we can see as he's speaking and going quiet, there's a little bit of microphone feedback going on here in the mid-range around 2.5K. There's that mic feedback. So we could easily clean something like that up. The way I'd do that is I'd use the spot healing tool. I'd make sure my brush is big enough to get it so I can use the curly brackets to make it smaller or bigger. And then I just go over that mic feedback and sort of paint it out like that. So I can very easily just do a couple of passes here, two or three passes, just to really try and remove that mic feedback and lower it down. And as you can see, it's kind of fading away as I do that. Okay, so the mic feedback is less there, but that hasn't helped with the repetition.
Today, I consider myself.
Now, what I can do is I can go ahead and grab this audio. Actually, I've already made a copy of that specific section. I'm going to go into multitrack. I'm going to call this Lou, and that'll save into my downloads folder. No worries there. And what I'll try and do is manually add some volume keyframes. I'm going to hit Shift E to get rid of the tracks I'm not using, and Control or Command and backslash to really zoom in. So now here what I can do is I can like paint in some volume sort of keyframes, if you like. And I can actually start to fade out where he's kind of repeating on himself. But this, of course, is very rough. Okay, so we're going to have to cut that further.
I consider myself.
And this is where it gets complex because he's reflecting over his original words. So what we can do is try and fade this out like so. Make it less prominent.
I consider myself.
Okay, I've done a little duck there. It's not the greatest.
The luckiest man.
And again, that is something that can completely go, so let's fade that out.
I consider myself the luckiest man.
And again, we're just going to try and fade out a little bit of this, but keep the man bit in. and get rid of that man bit there. So again, you can see this is painstaking. It's taking a lot of time.
On the face of the earth. On the face of the earth.
And then we can get rid of that earth bit at the end. So
on the face of the earth.
Oh dear. No, this is you see the kind of issues we're coming across here. Okay, so we got something there that we can potentially work with. Now, I did think through many different tools, by the way, just to show you that I'm not diving straight into multitrack and trying to do it manually. I did try many of the earlier tools that I've shown you in different videos, like denoise. Unfortunately, not working so well. 0 to 100%. Let's go to the start and play that back.
Today, I consider myself...
It cleans up the background noise, but unfortunately, that's not what we want. I can also try something like noise reduction restoration. We'll go for sound remover, and we'll try and train it on... We'll try and train it on a word that he says that is reflected, so we'll learn the sound model of that. But unfortunately... We can enhance for speech, of course.
I consider myself the luckiest man.
But of course, we'd have to train on the whole speech. So that's not working. Another idea I had is, well, what about if we cancel the phase? What if I take the left-hand side of this recording and copy it and then paste it on the right-hand side, like so? So I'm going to delete that, paste that in. And then as I do that, what if I go to effects and I invert the waveform? Now, if you invert a waveform and get it exact... with the other waveform, when you go to mono, so this is stereo, if you're listening in mono, you might not hear anything there. And then if I go to edit and convert sample type to mono, see, both sides cancel each other out. And I thought, what if I did that with the echo track and calculate exactly what's going on there? So again, we'll get rid of that and we'll listen.
Today.
So today starts, let's see here, probably about 0.473 seconds later, so nearly half a second. So if I go and find 0.7473, which is there, and then I paste this only onto the right track, maybe we can cancel out his echo with a phase inversion. This is complex stuff. I'm going to try it. Click OK to that. See, I've pasted that virtually.
Today.
We've got that now virtually lined up. You see the original is now matching up with the echo. Now, what if I go ahead and take the right track? This is overcomplicating in a way, isn't it? Edit, and we'll go to effects, and we'll invert that waveform, and now we'll bring it back to stereo, and now we'll try and do a phase cancellation by going to edit, convert sample type to mono. What happens?
Today, I consider myself.
And unfortunately, that phase cancellation just doesn't work because the waveform is not exactly the same, and it needs to be exactly the same to cancel out. So unfortunately, that didn't work. So I've got this squiggly thing in Audition. We're not doing too well, are we? Multitrack, mix down entire session. I've done a bit of a fade out there. Let's save that as Lou Improved, if you can call it that. And then I'm going to go back over to Descript right here, and I'm going to go ahead and bring in that Lou Improved version. So let's go and drag and drop this just about there. We'll let it come in, and we'll also add the effect of studio sound to this to see if the AI handles it better. So again, it's just going to take a few seconds to add studio sound to Lou Improved, and we'll see now if by me ducking out the reflections, mostly, it will actually clean up this audio. So give it just a moment, and then we'll play it back from the start here with the play button.
Today,
yeah, it's not.
I consider myself luckiest man on the face of the earth.
Okay, it's a bit better, but it's not perfect, is it? It really is not perfect. Okay, so we'll hop over into the premium solution, iZOTOPE RX. What kind of a job can iZOTOPE RX do? Let's go to Dialogue D Reverb, first of all, and we'll focus on the vocal detail preset. Let's listen to Lou Gehrig's speech going through this.
Today, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth.
Okay, that's still bringing quite a lot of the background noise. So let's go to extreme reduction and see how this handles things. Computing the preview.
Today, I consider myself the luckiest man.
That's not bad, but we can still hear the background stuff. Dialogue isolate is quite a good one. And if we actually go to isolate noise and run this, so this is just increasing the noise and getting rid of the dialogue. Sensitivity of 10, so really hard. Let's go preview on this and listen to it. Let's actually listen from the start. This is quite a CPU intensive effect, by the way, so it might take some time to render, but this is a good quality render. Oh, that's good. Now it's actually playing just the echo, so maybe we'll be lucky if we go dialogue gain to zero, noise gain to infinity, so basically muted out, and sensitivity to 10. Let's play this and hear what we get with our CPU.
Today, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth.
It's not perfect, but it's good. Let's go to best quality and try that again, because maybe best quality render will do even better. Let's play that.
Today, I consider myself the luckiest man on the face of the earth.
Okay, I reckon dialogue isolate with the noise gain turned right the way down, dialogue gain at neutral, sensitivity at 10 is probably the best result we have had yet. Well done, iZOTOPE RX. You are worth every single penny. Just for my own satisfaction, to make sure I've done the right things and gone to the right bits here, dialogue dereverb and dialogue isolate, probably using those in combination would get the best result here. I'm also going to run the repair assistant, which is fantastic. We can start from the start and say that this would be dialogue that we're trying to clean up. It's going to do its analysis of all of Lou Gehrig's speech, and then it's going to suggest some different chains, and we'll see if we can get a better result than I got with my specific effects using the AI that is included in iZOTOPE RX. So it's creating three different options for me to process this speech, and let's see what exactly we get. Okay, so we've got the original here.
Today, I consider myself...
Chain A.
Today, I consider myself...
Chain B.
Today, I consider myself...
Chain C.
Today...
And I have to say, I don't think they do as good a job as the effects that I chose. So you can see, actually, that there are different effects going into all of these different chains. But I reckon vocal dialogue dereverb and vocal dialogue isolate are going to be the way to go if using RX to clean up such a speech or something like this. Thanks for watching to the end, and let me know if there's a famous person who has a speech that you'd like me to clean up. Post it in the comments below, and I'll do my very best to make the magic happen. And if you want more awesome audio content, be sure to hit subscribe. If you've not done so already, check out musicradiocreative.com. This is where my team of 200-plus audio professionals can help you with voiceovers, radio jingles, DJ drops, podcast intros, music, ads, and much, much more. Until the next time, keep calm and produce on, my friends.
MusicRadioCreative.com